In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. You are all most welcome to our celebration here at St. Augustine's Church in Limerick, as we come to our last Mass of the year 2020. Inevitably, this is a time when we look both backwards and forwards. Backwards at rather a tumultuous year, but forwards with much hope, especially with the news of the administration of the vaccine against the virus. As we come into God's presence now, with all the thoughts flying around our minds, let us try to quieten ourselves, that we may hear better the word of God. Lord Jesus, you have given us the gift of life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to share our life. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you offer us eternal life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the nativity of your Son established the beginning and fulfilment of all religion, grant, we pray, that we may be numbered among those who belong to him, in whom is the fullness of human salvation, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our reading this afternoon is taken from the first letter of St. John. Children, these are the last days. You were told that an Antichrist must come, and now several Antichrists have already appeared. We know from this that these are the last days. Those rivals of Christ came out of your own number, but they had never really belonged. If they had belonged, they would have stayed with us. But they left us to prove that not one of them ever belonged to us. But you have been anointed by the Holy One and have all received the knowledge. It is not because you do not know the truth that I am writing to you, but rather because you know it already and know that no lie can come from the truth. The word of the Lord. Our response to the psalm this afternoon, let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. O sing a new song to the Lord, sing to the Lord all the earth. O sing to the Lord, bless his name, proclaim his help day by day. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Let the sea and all within it thunder praise. Let the land and all it bears rejoice. All the trees of the wood shout for joy at the presence of the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. With justice he will rule the world. He will judge the peoples with his truth. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. And now we welcome the words of the Gospel.
Hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things came to be. Not one thing had its being but through him. All that came to be had life in him, and that life was the light of men, a light that shines in the dark, a light that darkness could not overpower. A man came, sent by God. His name was John. He came as a witness to speak for the light, so that everyone might believe through him. He was not the light, only a witness to speak for the light. The Word was the true light that enlightens all people, and he was coming into the world. He was in the world that had its being through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own domain, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To all who believe in the name of him who was born not out of human stock or urge of the flesh or will of man, but of God himself. The Word was made flesh. He lived among us, and we saw his glory. The glory that is his as the only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. John appears as his witness. He proclaims, "This is the one of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks before me because he existed before me.' Indeed, from his fullness we have, all of us, received, yes, grace in return for grace. Since though the law was given through Moses, grace and truth have come through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is the only Son who is nearest to the Father's heart who has made him known." The Gospel of the Lord. So we come to the end of a year that probably many people would wish to put behind them as quickly as possible. This day last year, we looked forward to 2020, many of us full of hope and plans that were gradually dismantled as the year progressed, and we were left bewildered. It's a year that has tired us, stressed us, worried us, and affected us at so many levels. And yet the liturgy reminds us that as we mark the years, we do so in a very particular context, the context that is God. God who is outside time because he made time. In the beginning was the Word. This was the Word made flesh for us in Bethlehem. The one who knows the Father revealed himself to us, and through him we too can come to know the Father. That great gift overshadows all time. That's why whatever else has happened, we know that we rest secure in God's hand. The invitation to us always is to be, like John the Baptist, witnesses to the one who came. And all through this week, since Christmas Day, we have heard about different witnesses. We heard about Stephen, who gave his life for his faith. We heard about John the Evangelist, the one who wrote those words for us, "In the beginning was the Word." We heard about the babies murdered by Herod, recording that historical fact of the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem and Herod's attempt to kill him. We heard of Thomas Becket, murdered by Henry II because he refused to compromise his faith in the interests of politics. We hear also of Saint Sylvester, one of the early popes, who led the young church to a new phase of its life as it was given freedom in the Roman Empire. He was the pope, in fact, at the time of the Council of Nicaea, from where we have the creed that we profess normally on Sundays. Each one witnesses in their own way, in different ways, at different times, but all witnesses to the same truth, that God so loved the world, he sent his only Son. On this New Year's Eve, we are reminded of the Baptist, who came. He was not the light, he was a witness to the light. We are reminded that in a world that so often experiences darkness, we too are to be witnesses to the light of Christ. For all that has been, in the words of Teresa of Avila, thank you. For all that will be in this new year, thank you. Always knowing that we walk in God's hand and that we are the ones who will light the way for others to come to know the Father. God so loved the world that he sent his Son. Let's pray now for one another, asking the Lord to lead us gently through this new year, helping us to be signs of his love for those around us. Lord, hear us. We pray for peace in our world. So many parts of our world live through violence, war, and fear. We ask the Prince of Peace to make this a year where peace will make itself felt. Lord, hear us. We pray for all those involved in the various countries in the program of vaccination, asking the Lord to bless this effort, to bless all those involved, and to bring it to a successful fruition. Lord, hear us. And of course, as we let this year go, we can't do so without remembering those who have died during this year. So many more due to this coronavirus, but so many friends, neighbours, family members, colleagues, people whom we ourselves have known and have shared our lives with. We entrust them this afternoon to God's mercy, asking the Lord to grant them pardon and peace. Lord, hear us. In silence now for a moment, we entrust our own prayers, petitions, and needs to the Lord. Lord, hear us. God our Father, receive our petitions. We present them to you with confidence because we present them through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
In the words of the prophet is written a line, I will comfort my people, I will give them a sign, I will offer salvation, for now
that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and for the good of all God's holy church. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and in heart, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours. And begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Sign of our unity, the mystery of our faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Brendan our Bishop, and all who work for your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. So even though you may be on your own in your home, as I am here, we are many gathered around this altar this afternoon. So let us pray with one another and for one another in the words that Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May your people, O Lord, whom you guide and sustain in many ways, experience both now and in the future the remedies which you bestow, that with the needed solace of things that pass away, they may strive with ever deepened trust for things eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I take this opportunity to wish you all a very happy and blessed new year, especially a safe new year. We have come to appreciate being safe recently in a way we never expected to. Once again, obviously, we are in lockdown, but that doesn't mean we can't support one another and reach out to one another. I'd ask you to be aware of those who live alone, those who perhaps are elderly, those who perhaps are infirm. Remember them, not only in prayer, but also by a phone call or perhaps offering to get a message for them. Whatever else, please don't be lonely. We are many. We can help one another. Feel free any time to send an email by means of the website there. You can send a letter or a note to Father Noel, Augustinian Church, Limerick, and we can keep in touch that way. But most importantly, let's continue to pray with and for one another. A very happy new year. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the source and origin of all blessing, grant you grace, pour out his blessing in abundance, and keep you safe from harm throughout the year. Amen. May he give you integrity in the faith, endurance in hope, and perseverance in charity with holy patience to the end. Amen. May he order your days and your deeds in his peace, grant your prayers in this and in every place, and lead you happily to eternal life. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to continue to try to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.